Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even though I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go. That is coming for the heart that holds on, a glorious light beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you here on the earth. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. God is with me. Whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go. Through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go. Every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go. Oh Lord, you never let go. Keep on loving and you never let go. Sing it, oh no, you never let go. Through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go. Every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go. Lord, you never let go of me. Yes, I can see a light that is coming for the heart that holds on. There will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you. Still I will praise you.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. This week I want to talk about peace. And the good people here at the Quad Cities Botanical Center have allowed us to do this piece here. And we're really, really grateful. This is my first time here, and it is lovely. If you've never been here before, I strongly encourage it. If you've been here a number of times, come back again, because this is a really lovely, lovely spot. And it's a good spot to talk about peace, because in many ways and for many people, it's a place like this that encourages peace, that helps them to think about peace, whether it's the calm pond with the little fish, whether it's the trees and flowers around us, or a little walking path. Whatever it might be, places like the Botanical Center help us to take a break from our busy lives and just rest a little bit and relax. For some people, it's not nature. For some people, it's a book on a porch. For some people, it's the beach. For some people, it's just a quiet dinner with someone they love. But whatever it is, peace seems to be a little bit, well, in short supply these days. You know, Jesus said a lot about peace. And wherever it was, you know, he would go up the mountain to pray. He would have meals with the disciples. Wherever it is for you, peace is something that comes from really only one place. Hanging out, relaxing, resting, all of those things can help peace in little ways. But true peace, the kind of peace that Jesus talked about, is found in the absence of fear. Let me say that again. Fear is the greatest enemy of peace. Now, why do I say that? Well, because when we're afraid, whether it's something like being afraid of heights, whether it's afraid of a particular kind of animal, some people don't like spiders, whatever it is, fear creates all sorts of stuff that happens in our bodies, all sorts of stuff that happens in our minds, and it completely wipes out that sense of calm, that sense of hope, the sense of peace that Jesus talked about regularly. When he was leaving before his ascension, he said to his disciples, "My peace I leave with you, not as the world gives, but as I give." What he meant was not something short term, not something that can be here and then gone the next moment, but the kind of peace which Jesus knew that was rooted in the love of God, rooted in the beauty of God's creation, rooted in knowing that no matter what happens, no matter what happens, that peace is found when we let go of fear. When we say to fear of people, no. When we say to fear of things, no. When we say to fear of the future, no. When we say no to fear, we're well on the path to peace. Right now in our world, we know that peace is in short supply. We know that there is fighting all around the world. We know that there is disruption, pain, violence all over the place. But we will only have peace not when we just lay down the guns, not when we just figure out how to live within treaties and agreements. We will only have peace when we stop fearing our neighbor, when we stop the fear of people who are different than we are, when we stop the fear of not having enough money, not having enough status, not having enough of anything. Instead, when we root ourselves in God's love, when we root ourselves in the absolute knowledge, trust, and faith that whatever we have and whatever we need will come first from God, that we will never be abandoned no matter how dark it seems, when we know that promise, when we know that promise, fear melts away and hope and peace arrive. So I wish for you this week peace. Perhaps you can come to a place like this, the Quad Cities Botanical Center, and sit for a moment and relax and rest. But that's only the start. I encourage you to take that time wherever it is, and consider what you fear. Consider what makes you afraid, and see how you might let it go, how you might get rid of it and not have it control you, your mind or your body. Then you'll know peace. It's what we're all looking for, really. Amen.
Storm inside, it brings me to my knees. Nowhere to hide, this weight is crippling. Come speak to the sea that's raging inside of me. All of this worry, you I will release. I cast my cares at your feet. Take it all, take it all. I trade my fear for your peace. Take it all. Pull me up when I feel beneath. You clear the skies. You are my soul's relief. Come speak to the sea that's raging inside of me. All of this world I will release. I cast my cares at your feet. Take it all, take it all. I trade my fear for your peace. Take it all, take it all. Give me your peace. Let your peace fall down from your hand to my heart. Let your peace fall down, 'cause it's who you are. Let your peace fall down from your hand to my heart. Let your peace fall down, 'cause it's who you are. Let your peace fall down from your hand to my heart. Let your peace fall down, 'cause it's who you are. Take it all, take it all. I train my fear for your peace. Take it all, take it all. I cast my cares at your feet. And take it all. I train my fear for your peace. Take it all, and take it all.
Let's take a moment in the midst of these beautiful surroundings to pray together, offer our prayers to God. Lord, you remind us in your word that perfect love casts out all fear. And so if we want to have peace, we know that we must love. And we know that we must resist all of the pressures to be afraid. Resist all of the pressure to worry about money and status and health and all of the things that frighten us. Help us especially to not fear our neighbor. Yes, we're different. We have different skin colors. We have different religious beliefs. We have different ways that we think about the world. We have different ideas about politics. All of those things are true, and that's okay, until they create fear in one another. Because in that sense, we will never know peace. Help the nations of the world, help all of us put pressure on the nations of the world to stop their fighting, to stop their fear, to stop violence, and know real peace. Not just temporary or tentative. Be with our cities, our towns, our rural areas, all around our country and our world, that we might work to preserve open spaces, the kinds of spaces where people can rest and renew and find some moment of peace while they work for a larger peace. Help us to make smart decisions about our environment so that it is with us always. We must sustain it as it sustains us. And finally, Lord, be with each of us each day. Comfort us in the knowledge that you are with us, that no matter what happens, as the Apostle Paul wrote, nothing, nothing, nothing can separate us from your love. And when we know that, when we know that no matter what, we are not separated from you, then we might know that peace that Jesus said to his disciples, a peace that is not from this world, but from you. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen.